In the previous video, we created the toggle switch system. Now we'll see how we can style it to make it stand out. We will create two versions, both inheriting from the base toggle switch. We start with making a few needed tweaks to the base script, so inheriting works as intended. Slider value needs to change from being private to protected. This way, inheriting scripts can get access to it without having to make it public. OnValidate needs to be protected as well. Awake gets set to protected virtual. We want to override the awake method in our inheriting scripts, which will only work if we use virtual here. Create a protected action transition effect and invoke it like this inside the animation slider. You can think of this action as a placeholder. In the scripts that inherit from our base class, we assign a method which handles the color or image transitions to this. When animation slider calls for the invoke, it will then run whichever method is assigned to a transition effect. This means we can avoid having to rewrite the same code in animate slider for different transition effects and keep our code more centralized and easier to manage. Our first switch version is this color changing one. It inherits from the core toggle switch script, so we can focus on the color logic here. We need references to the parts we want to recolor. In this case, I want the background and handle image and have checks for if either of those should be recolored at all. Grouped under the colors header, each image's on and off state will get a color assigned to it. By defaulting to the white through code, the alpha channel inside the color picker will already be set to maximum, which will get rid of that one click more we have to do if we don't give a starting value. These two bools check if either of the background or handle image are null. OnValidate has no override, it seems, so we will write a new OnValidate that calls the base's OnValidate like this. Also, we will call changeColors here, which will be the heart of the system in a moment. In OnEnable and OnDisable, which we haven't used before, we will subscribe to and unsubscribe from setOnChangeColor method. In Awake, which is a protected override method in this case, we call the baseAwake method and then check if any of our images are nulled. ChangeColor is a very short method. If we set up our background and handle images correctly, we can change the color based on the loop value from the initial color to the destination color based on the slider's value. Because we registered this method to transition effect, whenever the logic of our sliders run, it will get called right here and recolor our elements as needed. The logic is the same for all kinds of images, so you can experiment with decorations on the toggle switches as well. Just keep in mind that these UI elements are usually not terribly large, so super intricate designs won't really work. If this tutorial is at all helpful to you, please give it a like to let me know. Subscribe if you want to learn more about UI topics. Onwards to transitioning from one image to the next depending on our slider's value. We can't lerp from one image to the next just by script like we did before. This time, we will need a shader material we create in Shader Graph. Make sure you have Shader Graph installed, and you can find it in the Unity registry under Shader Graph. I'm using a URP project with this version of Shader Graph. Right-click in your folder and create a new Shader Graph, Sprite Unlit Shader Graph. This is what the complete shader will look like. First, create three texture 2D by clicking on the plus here. Call them Main Text, Texture On, and Texture Off. When you click on Main Text, you can set an initial value here. Drag your button shape into this and untick Exposed. Texture On and Texture Off will also get default texture set up, but they will remain exposed. This way we can change their values in the inspector later on. Main Text, on the other hand, will just grab the source image of the image component, so we don't have to have it exposed. Drag Texture On and Texture Off into the window. Click and drag from the connection dot to the right. A new window will pop up. Enter Sample Texture into it and pick the Sample Texture 2D entry. Click anywhere to the right into the empty space, hit the space bar and enter lerp. That node works just like the color lerp we used in the previous class, just this time we can also use it to lerp from one image to the other. Set it up like this. We need a value that manages how these two entries should transition, called mixed value. Create a new float for it and set its mode to slider with a minimum of 0 and a maximum of 1. Drag it next to the node and link it up like this. You can test the effect already by changing the default value at this point. This texture effect needs to be overlaid on top of the source image of our image component. To do so, drag the main text into the window, sample it again, and create a node by clicking in the empty space, tapping on the spacebar and entering blend. Hook up the two nodes like this, set the opacity to 0 and mode to screen. The result gets linked up to the base color of the shader, and because we might need some alpha to get the shape of the image, drag a connection from the main text alpha entry to the alpha value of the fragment. Your shader should now look like this. Click Save. Right-click on the shader in the project and create a new material for the background. Because our handle will be using the exact same shader, repeat this step for the handle material as well. Again, create a new script and let it inherit from ToggleSlider. This time, we not only need image references for the background and handle image, but we will also need the material to use for it in the local copy of the material. This copy is important, since if we just assign the material itself to every ToggleSlider, it would change on all of them, not just the one being interacted with. We need a few bools to check if everything has been set up correctly. In onValidate, which again has the new keyword, we call the base method and set up materials as well and transition the images. Awake, which is again labeled as protected override, calls the base awake and checks the setup. In setup materials, we create local copies of the background and handle materials like this and assign them accordingly. Just like in the color changing one, we subscribe to and unsubscribe from the effect method in onEnable and onDisable respectively. This time it's being called transition images. If they have been set up correctly, we can set the float of our mix value we declared inside the shader like this based on the slider value. How do you like the effect? I think they look really cool, though maybe this last one isn't the everyday version of every slider in your game. I would default to a subtle version of the color changing one for most instances, since creating dedicated images even for small elements like this toggle switch do take time and effort. But for special sliders like dark and light themes, this can be a neat effect. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial.